and 1.5 pounds, wearing black trunks, Thad Spencer. In this corner, from Atlantic City, New Jersey, and Chicago, Illinois, weighing 214.5 pounds, the former WBA heavyweight of the world champion, Ernie Terrell.
Knocked down, he must go to the farthest corner of the man on the street, and I'll count to 8. Understand? You know all the rest of the rules, holding behind the head and all that. Please don't hold. Fight out of the clinches. I'll give you every chance.
If a stare will win about.
Please try. Now fight hard on the inside, please, boys. Make a good fight.
There it is, the 12th round. World Heavyweight Championship Elimination Bout. The second here on ABC's Wide World of Sports Today. And there will be more later in weeks to come. In the white trunks, 6 feet 6, 214.5 pounds, Ernie Terrell, who's won 39-44 and has fought a lot of fine heavyweights. 24-year-old Thad Babe Spencer in the black trunks, 201.5. Let's watch him.
I'd seek to surprise Terrell with right leads to that eye that was damaged in the fight against Ali.
All right, let's see if he does. Here's that awesome left hand of Ernie Terrell. And in close, he is doing plenty of damage, too, with 2 minutes remaining in the first round, scheduled for 12. Hear the referee Jimmy Webb telling them to punch out of the clinches. On the part of both fighters, you can undoubtedly hear the audio that goes along with the punches. In the black trunks, born in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, then moved to Portland, Oregon, now lives in San Francisco. Some heavy punches are landing. Less than a minute, round one. And a left like Terrell's has to keep you off balance. Yet Spencer is showing plenty in trying to get inside of it. We'll watch the left eye of Thad Spencer in the black trunks. There's a lot of scar tissue on that side of his face. Less than 10. On the part of all the handlers in both corners, very quietly went about their jobs. Neither fighter marked. This is round two. Spencer in the black trunks at 201.5. Terrell, much taller, 13 pounds heavier, in white. Watch that left hand of Terrell. Wow. Of course, a left-hand lead, a left jab or hook is open for a right-hand cross very often. And we can look for that, too, on the part of Spencer and Black. About 2 minutes remaining in the second round. Pretty hard for Spencer, who's shorter, to keep the punches above the belt to the body.
Counting for the knockdown. And let's see if Spencer can do it.
A minute and 5 seconds remaining in round two. Terrell down for a count. That's quite an achievement, Howard, on the part of any fighter to do that to Terrell.
That's true, but Chris, you heard us predict the right-hand lead.
About 40 seconds. Terrell obviously trying to shake those cobwebs. Thad Spencer scoring a knockdown in round two. Jimmy Webb, the referee, working hard to break the clinches. Good body punch by Terrell. And now the cut is open over the left eye, slight cut over the left eye of Thad Spencer. What a round, round two here at the Astrodome.
It was a whale of a boxing round. Spencer has cut over the left eye and a slight cut on the bridge of the nose. But Spencer did use that right lead, which is the way to get past Terrell's left, to avoid the left and come back with that right lead. And Ernie, well, his dignity was hurt, but more than that, he was shaken up. Still, Terrell is fighting not the way he fought in his last fight here in the Astrodome. He is using the left, and until Spencer led with that right, he was having trouble getting inside of Terrell's left. Terrell, you'll remember, fought in that peekaboo style in his last fight. There's a lot of battle in both of these guys yet, unless Spencer's eye turns real bad, Chris.
And the speed factor on the part of the younger Thad Spencer, he really unloads that right hand.
It's the hand speed, Chris. A lot of people think he's got the fastest hands in boxing.
Terrell will have to agree with you if he's honest, because he caught it right on the chin and went down. Little rubbery legs as he comes out of the corner now for round three. Terrell and the white trunks. He's very carefully looking over the cut over Spencer's left eye, which was closed between rounds. Are heavy punches that Spencer is trying to land.
Chris,
now the
Spencer
cut is reopened.
Complaining of pain in his side. Forgive me for interrupting you. In his corner, he complained of a pain in his side.
Well, a few low blows here. Coming up to the 2 minute mark of the third round. Doesn't look as though it'll go 12, does it? Spencer, like Terrell, has beaten Doug Jones. Spencer's beaten Brian London. Billy Daniels. Minute 20, round three.
Notice Terrell's left eye, the one that was operated on, is beginning to look red.
Terrific give and take in close. Blocked in the arm by Terrell. Spencer's corner saying action in the belly. In other words, go for that bread basket. Time left, round three. And now the cut over Spencer's left eye, giving him trouble as he wipes away the blood. Watch the fourth round, scheduled for 12. If you just joined us, Terrell in the white trunks was down at 128 of the second round for a count. Tried to pace himself in round three. Let's see what he'll do here in the fourth round. Spencer had the cut over his left eye closed by the cornerman.
Spencer is getting to and hurting Terrell in the midsection.
And he's a pretty good predictor, Howard. I believe he told you he was going to do that.
Exactly.
Less than 2 minutes. This is the fourth round. There you saw Spencer trying to get across that left arm of Terrell. Spencer in black actually snaps away and slips a lot of the left hands and causes them to be nothing more than glancing blows. Minute 15.
Crowd doesn't like to see Ernie prove himself the octopus as once he was dubbed, Chris.
Yes, he becomes quite a heavyweight, especially it's really like break power when they lean on their opponent. Minute to go. Changing direction on trying to get the Spencer. Most of the time, he goes right to Spencer's right hand. Fourth round, about over. And now, for a few moments, let's go back to New York and Jim McKay.
Thank you, Chris. I just wanted to comment that this heavyweight tournament is certainly off to a real fast start, with Jimmy Ellis being the first man to move into the semifinals by TKOing Leotis Martin in the ninth round of their fight, and now this fine one going between Ernie Terrell and Thad Spencer. Big one's coming up, September 16th. Don't forget this, another quarterfinal bout, live by the satellite from Frankfurt, Germany, Argentina's Oscar Bonavena against the number one ranked challenger at the moment and the European heavyweight champion, Carl Mildenberger of Germany. Then on October 28th, it's going to be former champion Floyd Patterson going against young Jerry Quarry in Los Angeles. There should be another top one, then the semifinals, and eventually leading on to the final early next year. That's the way this heavyweight elimination tournament is going to work. Right now, as we said, off to a real fast start. So let's get back to it and back to the action with Chris Schenkel in Houston.
Okay, Jim McKay, get comfortable now because this is the fifth round. All of the viewers. Here's Thad Spencer, who scored the only knockdown in the fight, coming in the second round at about the midpoint. Terrell in the white trunks. Again, the corner closed the what appears to be a slight cut over the left eye of Spencer. ...28-year-old Ernie Terrell, 24-year-old Thad Spencer. Little left hook thrown by Spencer as Terrell was coming in caused Ernie to blink. Now the cut is reopened considerably over the left eye of Spencer. 2 minutes to go, round five. Punch high on the forehead. And Spencer right back to that body. Webb, the referee, is watching the face of Ernie Terrell very closely, especially the left eye. Doesn't appear to be any trouble as a result of it, but of course, Howard told you, this is the eye that was injured in this very same ring in February. Minute to go. And a beautiful left hook by Ernie Terrell has Spencer down. Let's see the time. About 51 seconds remaining here in the fifth round. Let's see what Terrell can do with a move, hold everything. So both fighters have been down with 30 seconds to go in round five. A tremendous heavyweight bout.
This will surprise a lot of the denizens of the dugout in New York City.
They'll both need this rest of 1 minute.
That was a whale of a round, Chris. I honestly didn't think that Terrell should seek to make a fight. I've had long talks with the people who know Terrell best among opposition managers who've studied him through the years, and they've always felt that if Terrell seeks to put out another guy, he can't do it and he's going to get himself in trouble. But Ernie, stung by the knockdown in the second round, went ahead with that strategy anyway, and for the fifth round at least it paid off. Actually, we now have the scoring even at the end of five rounds. 47 points for Terrell, 47 for Spencer. And I'll tell you this, Spencer's eye is now really damaged, the left eye. That cut can be reopened very readily by Terrell's swift left jab, and it seems much more punishing than I've seen it in a long time.
Just beautifully timed, snapping off as he flicks it out there with a lot of power, and he did it with a sort of a half-hook jab and dropped Spencer for a count. Here we go now into the sixth round. There's that jab, the very, very first punch by Terrell. Oh. Notice Spencer was trying to pick off those jabs with his gloves. Good left hand by Spencer. Terrell coming in. It's the second time that Terrell has gotten caught as he moves in. Terrell, but he got out of it all right by being backed into a corner with that left hook you saw. You just joined us. Both fighters have been on the deck. Terrell at 128 of the second round, and Spencer with 51 seconds of the fifth round remaining was on the canvas. About a minute 15 to go, round six. Minute to go. Maneuverable Ernie Terrell now. And now the cut over the left eye of Spencer, reopened and bleeding heavily. Good shot by Terrell.
He's chewing that eye up now.
As you see, 10 seconds left in round six, the halfway point, the scheduled 12-rounder.
Low back pain. It may have started days earlier with stress and strain that can painfully bind up muscles in the sensitive lower back. Reach for Anacin. Anacin relieves pain, so relaxes muscles. Anacin has the compound doctors prescribe most for back pain. In minutes, Anacin will relieve the pain, so stiff muscles loosen up to let you more freely move and move.
Some of the nicest feet get athlete's foot. For athlete's foot, get Enzactin. Enzactin helps stop athlete's foot fungus dead in its tracks without burn or irritation. All day long, Enzactin works on a controlled release principle. Releases medication when you need it most. Soothes the itch, destroys the fungus to help heal the infection. Best of all, Enzactin helps stop athlete's foot fungus dead in its tracks without burn or irritation.
An eight-man tournament to select a new heavyweight champion. Here are two of the contenders. Fourth-ranked Ernie Terrell against fifth-ranked Thad Spencer in the black trunks. In the first bout in the elimination tournament, Jimmy Ellis won in the ninth round over Leotis Martin.
Spencer's a tough kid, Chris. He's a busy fighter. He's always doing something in that ring. He's always after you. And this round, he opened with a good left to Terrell's head.
Good right hand over that left lead. Spencer throwing it. And you notice Terrell now is throwing the jabs from longer range. Not quite in enough to snap them off as he did, especially in the first and second rounds.
But being cautious, patiently reopening that cut over the left eyelid, figuring that in the long run, it's got to produce victory for him. He's a seasoned fighter, Chris.
Really is. Defeated Zora Foley, Eddie Machen, Doug Jones, George Chevallo. And now Spencer has a nosebleed. Got an idea how a good jab can keep the fighter off balance. You saw Spencer wanting to throw a punch but couldn't. A volley of punches coming at him. Round 7. Round 7.
Dad? Hasn't Susan Lindquist made an appointment for her wedding portrait yet?
Last time I heard from her was when I showed her proofs of her engagement pictures.
But they were great.
Yeah, but she and her mother acted kind of funny. Like I had bad breath.
Dad, that's no problem.
What do you mean?
Use Listerine.
Mouthwash is too sweet. As sweet as soda pop.
Not Listerine. It has a clean, fresh taste. And besides, Listerine kills germs.
Germs?
Germs can cause bad breath.
But you know how brides are. Their pictures can take hours.
Mm-hmm. And Listerine keeps breath fresh for hours.
How about that? I'll give it a try. Now, turn profile, Susan.
That's going to be a great shot, Dad.
Business is picking up lately, thanks to you, Paula.
Me?
Well, maybe Listerine?
Listerine antiseptic kills germs, keeps breath fresh for hours.
The perspiring face of 6'6" Ernie Terrell, who was down in the second round, and he decked Thad Spencer in the black trunks in the 5th round in a whale of a heavyweight elimination bout. As you see the difference in height, the argument continues on which is easier and more effective, to punch down or to punch up in the case of a shorter man. Spencer's been concentrating on the body, trying to get inside.
Terrell is concentrating on the eye and has it opened up again.
To go in the 8th round. The menacing left hand of Terrell. Again.
I'll tell you, Chris, Spencer keeps Terrell honest.
You know, the Marquis of Queensbury, when he made the rules for boxing, he made the ring this size for a reason, so that fighters could maneuver, and Terrell is forced to do it. Cut reopened over the left eye of Spencer. 50 seconds left in round 8. Good left hook by Thad Spencer. On the side of the face is Terrell. You'll hear the bell in 10 seconds.
I'm Jim McKay in New York again, and while we have a few seconds, I'd like to take a quick look into the future of ABC Sports. First of all, wide world of sports. Next week, it's going to be the Americas against Europe in a track meet from Montreal, Canada, that really should be exciting. And on that same day, by satellite from London, Jim Ryan running in a mile race that same day over there. 2 weeks from today, the National AAU Women's Outdoor Swimming and Diving Championships, live in part from Philadelphia, along with the Gold Cup Powerboat Race for Unlimited Hydroplanes. Other events in the near future on Wide World, the Little League World Series, the America's Cup Yacht Races, the Southern 500 Stock Car Race. On September 16th, NCAA football returns exclusively on ABC with SMU against Texas A&M. And on that same day, by satellite from Frankfurt, another fight, it'll be Carl Mildenberger against Oscar Bonavena. Next year, well, in February, the Winter Olympics from Grenoble. In October, the Summer Olympics from Mexico City. So stay with us all the way. Now let's get back to the fight.
Okay, Jim, and the WBA Elimination Tournament is getting off to a fast start right here in Houston, Texas, live on Wide World of Sports. Terrell in white, Spencer in the black trunks. This is round 9. Scheduled for 12. Another good body punch by Thad Spencer. Spencer on the far side. There's a cut on his cheekbone, about an inch and a half beneath his right eye.
And yet he's become the steady aggressor in the bout.
Terrell is very methodically trying to avoid those blows to the midsection. Minute to go. And it appears that Terrell's job will be to either get a lot of jabs through or stay away from those body punches, which could be his undoing. Good left to the chin of Terrell. Another one by Spencer. Round 9. As you see, 10 to go. As you know, there have been 2 knockdowns in this fight. Terrell in the second and then Spencer in the fifth. And from another angle, videotape, let's see how Terrell did deck Spencer in the fifth round.
Ready!
a different angle. Videotape round five. As you'll see, it was a punishing left hook. Jimmy Webb, the referee, is watching the face of Ernie Terrell very closely, especially the left eye. Doesn't appear to be any trouble as a result of it, but of course, Howard told you this is the eye that was injured in this very same ring in February. Minute to go. Videotape. Fifth round knockdown. There it is.
Oh, beautiful.
That was round five. He survived it. Now we're back live. It's the 10th round of the scheduled 12 rounder.
That was round five, Chris. The last two rounds, Spencer has made a big comeback. We have the score all even at 85 points apiece.
And of course, in no event will there be a draw in this elimination tournament.
That's correct.
The first bout between Jimmy Ellis and Leotis Martin ended at 143 of the ninth round with Ellis the winner. And we saw Martin a while ago, and he was heavily bandaged and taped around his nose, and that was the reason for referee Ernie Taylor stopping the bout. And now Jimmy Webb warns Terrell. Low blows, and he may have not noticed sort of an arm rabbit punch on the neck of Spencer. Very often those punches are accidental.
Was low again.
Thad Spencer leading with a right hand. He did catch Jarrell. Remember, Spencer is only 24 years old. Jarrell is 28. We have 50 seconds left in round 10. Two rounds to go. They saw low blows. Ten rounds completed here at the Houston Astrodome. And that is the farthest that Spencer has ever gone as we look very carefully over into the corner of Ernie Terrell now.
The referee has taken 2 points away from Terrell for low blows during that round, Chris. He just motioned at the side of the ring. The camera right now is on Thad Spencer, and there are some things you can't see on a screen. No attempt here to dramatize, but you can't see Spencer's eyes as he pursues Terrell. You heard him say before the fight, and he didn't want to be a ham and eggs guy anymore. And that's what's motivating this fellow now. He's a hungry fighter. And he's proving it.
Willie Ketchum, his manager, and Chickie Ferrara working Willie on the cut over the left eye, and Chickie Ferrara the cut on the right cheek. All over in the corner of Terrell, Sam Solomon talks to him very confidently, and Terrell keeps staring away at Thad Spencer, and here they meet. Round 11. Terrell, managed by George Hammett Jr., sportsman and showman from Atlantic City, New Jersey.
Hey,
scoring here down on the 10-point must. And remember that 2 points were taken away from Terrell in the 10th round for low blows, the referee giving the penalty. With the closeness of this fight, and we're in the 11th round, that 12th and final round should be a dilly. 2 minutes left in the 11th.
Terrell looks tired, Chris. He's bouncing, but that's about it. What he's trying to do is stay away, and then he's holding and clutching.
And you don't see that zip in those left jabs and hooks that were present earlier. Fighters landing solid punches.
It's an odd position for Ernie to be in this Astrodome ring. It was he who claimed that he had been fouled the last time he fought him.
Right. A minute to go, round 11. Strategy certainly has changed. Body blows add up, and they usually take their toll later in a bout. Don't necessarily take a fighter out as punches to the head or chin. Fifteen seconds, as you see, round 11. One round to go. A short chopping punch. There's the end of round 11 with the Big 12 coming up. In the meantime, let's go to Jim McKay.
So the battle goes on, and next week we'll be in Montreal, Canada for the first Americas versus Europe track and field meet. The two top men and women competitors from Europe will meet their two top counterparts from the Americas in each event in this truly unique competition. Such outstanding competitors as the shot put world record holder Randy Matson, Olympic long jump champion Lynn Davies of Great Britain, and his rival, the great American world champion Ralph Boston, will be competing in this historic track and field competition. Should really be something. Also next week, via early bird satellite, you'll see America's great world record holder Jim Ryan competing against a great field, including Kenya's Kipchoge Keino and Bodo Tumler of West Germany. Also, a look at the surprising Boston Red Sox, the team now battling it out for the American League pennant. That'll be next week on ABC's Wide World of Sports. The fight goes on in Houston. Let's go back to Chris.
Back again, Ernie Terrell coming out quickly to touch the glove, signifying the 12th and final round. A tired-looking Ernie Terrell, rubbery legs. Pat Spencer, let's see what he can do. Each fighter has been knocked down.
Very quickly, Chris, we have Spencer ahead on points, 105 to 102, without that deduction for low blows.
Around does look a little awkward. He almost stepped on the opposite foot a while ago, which indicates that he is really tired. Two minutes left in the scheduled 12-round elimination bout. Trying to unload.
He looks desperate, Chris. Absolutely desperate. We can't judge this fight for the officials, but I think Ernie senses a defeat he never expected.
The West Coast in Thad Spencer battling Ernie Terrell from Atlantic City and Chicago. Calls both places his home. A minute and 5 seconds left in this heavyweight bout. Terrell and White was down in the second. Spencer was down in the fifth. And Terrell is really tired. Seconds left in the bout.
Him if I give it back.
Chris Jordan and Ernie Taylor are the judges. Jimmy Webb, the referee. Seconds. The limit. The second here this afternoon, live from the Astrodome. Ernie Terrell, who was down in the second round, came back to down Spencer in the fifth round. In the tenth round, 2 points were deducted from the total of Terrell because of low blows, the referee giving the penalty. This is a 10-point must scoring system here in the state of Texas. So if you're scoring the fight, remember it. And soon we'll know just how Chris Jordan and Ernie Taylor, the judges, and the referee Jimmy Webb looked at this fight. If you just joined us in the first fight, Leotis Martin on a TKO loss to Jimmy Ellis at 143 of the ninth round because of an injury to the nose and a heavy nosebleed. So the World Boxing Association Elimination Tournament is underway. The quarterfinals. There you get a look at Ernie Terrell, who unmarked in the fight. There's his manager, George Hammett Jr. And Spencer and Terrell close together now, cooperating with the still photographers as we're showing you the picture live from the Astrodome. George Hammett looks very serious. He's quite a sportsman, quite a gentleman. Owner of the Steel Pier in Atlantic City. So now, up in the ring, let's go to Howard Cosell.
Gentlemen, as you know, we're awaiting the decision. I just, Ernie, want you to tell Thad Spencer, and please face the camera if you will. Gentlemen, will you get out of the way? Tell the folks what you said to me as I came into the ring, Ernie, right after the
fight.
Do you expect the decision, Ernie? You expect the decision. And you expect that you've won.
Yes, I do. I don't think we're that close.
All right, gentlemen, that's the way it is. That's the way it should be. And one of us, or one of you, is going to be proved wrong. We're awaiting the announcement now. Thad, I must say this. Until the eighth round, I felt you were behind, but you came back very strongly after that. You realized then that you were assuming control of the fight.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I thought I had control in the earlier round, and I slowed up for a purpose. I slowed up to just rest for two rounds, six, seven, eight. Then I figured to come on.
Yet he decked you in the fifth.
I think that was more of a slip. I wasn't hurt, if you noticed, but I decked him.
You didn't think you were cleanly hit by the left hook?
No, that was a slip. I was backing up. I was pulling out.
Now, your strategy was to lead with the right.
I think the referee knew it was a slip because he didn't count.
All right, your strategy was to lead with the right. You got that from your manager, Willie Ketchum.
Yes, I did, but I found I could jab him, too.
This is Willie Ketchum, of course, taking off Thad Spencer's gloves. Willie Ketchum, who looks for all the world like a manager depicted by the late Damon Runyon. Let's go back quickly to Chris.
And now Tim Nolan. Here is the scoring.
Points. Thad Spencer, 116.
So on Chris Jordan's card, Spencer gets it by 6 points. Now let's listen.
Chris Jordan, Ernie Terrell, 110 points. Thad Spencer, 118.
So there it is, ladies and gentlemen. With one more card to be put in. Let's see what it is. The referee now.
Ernie Terrell, 110 pounds. Thad Spencer, 118.
There it is. 110 for all three of the officials for Terrell. 118, 118, and 116. A unanimous victory and an upset victory here at the Astrodome. Thad Spencer is the winner. And now, in this historic doubleheader, we leave Houston and back to New York and Jim McKay.
That's all.